the person I was sophomore year of high school would know that I would go to Wellesley. She would think I would be a poli sci or an econ major. I didn't have my own computer until I bought a laptop to have with me in college. So it just seemed so out of the blue that I would develop this interest. But I'm really glad that I took that computer science course.
That's a perfect one.
I've always been interested in art, and I think that's why I like media arts and sciences so much, because it's that integration of computer science and art, and I'm probably making my mom a lot less anxious than if I were just a studio art major.
In every moment, there are new ways of thinking about artwork and new ways of engaging it. Today, we have the opportunity to use technology to really enhance and expand everyone's access to these objects. Ma Cherie's project brings together different aspects of her learning, and I think that Wellesley encourages that kind of experimental thinking and that kind of realization of an ambitious project that you would not be able to really manage in a larger environment.
The iPhone application really focuses on engagement and reflection in the gallery. So someone comes in and they choose a piece, and immediately they just choose it because they're attracted to it, but then the questions prompt them to become engaged with the piece on a deeper level. It might ask them to mimic the way a statue is standing or think about the mood of the piece, and hopefully it'll get them to think and brainstorm about art in a way that they never had before. I started working with Consuelo because she is probably one of the best iPhone programmers that we have at Wellesley, and so I think it was a really good match.
I'm a huge human-computer interaction geek and a gadget geek. I really want to create things that are more intuitive. Sometimes it's not easy for you to see, oh, I'm supposed to touch this button, or this is actually a button. This is going to be the gradient, and then here's going to be the actual image.
Can we see it on the simulator?
Maybe.
This one is holding the picture frame.
In most other jobs, you really don't have a great chance in changing the world around you. Most disciplines are so old and well-formed that a new person's attempt will usually have very limited effect. In computing today, in the way that we're using multimedia and the interfaces, the way we are experiencing the social web, all of these things have a tremendous effect, and you get a chance to actually make some small changes that can have a great effect on people. In case of Ma Cherie, the application she created allows people to experience the museum in a different way. Their next visit to the museum is not going to be like the previous one. She has already influenced what they saw, how they saw it, and how they're thinking about it.
Even if I don't always work in a field related to art museums, as long as I can look up a problem and try to find a technological approach to solving that problem, I'm still doing something that I'm interested in doing. There aren't a lot of women in the industry, and I think without Wellesley, I definitely would not have become interested in computer science at all.
Limited effect. In computing today, in the way that we're using multimedia and the interfaces, the way we are experiencing the social web, all of these things have a tremendous effect, and you get a chance to actually make some small changes that can have a great effect on people. In case of Ma Cherie, the application she created allows people to experience the museum in a different way. Their next visit to the museum is not going to be like the previous one. She has already influenced what they saw, how they saw it, and how they're thinking about it.
Even if I don't always work in a field related to art museum,
larger environment.
The iPhone application really focuses on engagement and reflection in the gallery. So someone comes in and they choose a piece, and immediately they just choose it because they're attracted to it, but then the questions prompt them to become engaged with the piece on a deeper level. It might ask them to mimic the way a statue is standing or think about the mood of the piece, and hopefully it'll get them to think and brainstorm about art in a way that they never had before. I started working with Consuelo because she is probably one of the best iPhone programmers that we have at Wellesley, and so I think it was a really good match. If the person I was sophomore year of high school would know that I would go to Wellesley, she would think I would be a poli sci or an econ major. I didn't have my own computer until I bought a laptop to have with me in college. So it just seemed so out of the blue that I would develop this interest. But I'm really glad that I took that computer science course.
That's a perfect one.
I've always been interested in art, and I think that's why I like media arts and sciences so much, because
I'm a huge human-computer interaction geek and a gadget geek. I really want to create things that are more intuitive. Sometimes it's not easy for you to see, oh, I'm supposed to touch this button, or this is actually a button. This is going to be the gradient, and then here's going to be the actual image.
Can we see it on the simulator?
Maybe.
This one that looks good. Picture frame,
in most other jobs, you really don't have a great chance in changing the world around you. Most disciplines are so old and well-formed that a new person's attempt will usually have very
little. Because it's that integration of computer science and art, and I'm probably making my mom a lot less anxious than if I were just a studio art major.
In every moment, there are new ways of thinking about artwork and new ways of engaging it. Today, we have the opportunity to use technology to really enhance and expand everyone's access to these objects. Ma Cherie's project brings together different aspects of her learning, and I think that Wellesley encourages that kind of experimental thinking and that kind of realization of an ambitious project that you would not be able to really manage in a